addition to the presidential election, a group from Southern California wants an initiative on the November ballot that would tighten immigration laws in California.
Significantly, yeah. Today, the Secretary of State gave them the go-ahead to start collecting signatures. It's not Arizona-style immigration law, but it's close. In the proposal, California cops would be forced to hand over any illegal immigrant that breaks the law over to the feds.
With more on the initiative and how things would change if it is passed, here's Action News reporter Tom Miller, who joins us live from Salinas.
Well, Aaron, this isn't going over well with local labor groups who work to protect many of the illegal immigrants who work here on the Central Coast. They say it would add a lot more people to the jail system and kick out people who work to keep our local economy flowing.
It's called the California Taxpayer Protection Act of 2012. But the Central Coast immigrant community says it won't protect anyone and instead would deport hardworking people.
If they wanted to work in the fields, they would have already been doing it. But it's something they don't want to do.
Anna Oviedo is studying tonight to become an American citizen. Her parents work in agriculture and she goes to college locally. The initiative says that no person without lawful immigration status shall be eligible for any state-funded grant, scholarship, or student financial aid, something Oviedo calls unfair.
Unfair, because everybody deserves an education. Not just because you're illegal means you get kicked to the side.
The initiative also wants to make it illegal for an undocumented immigrant to get a driver's license, which is strange because according to the DMV's website, that's already illegal.
Another section says that cops in custody of an illegal immigrant may not release the alien unless otherwise directed by a court of competent jurisdiction, but shall transfer the alien into federal custody.
It's proposing a drastic change in California to actually make local law enforcement's federal agents.
Cesar Lara is the executive director at the Monterey-based Central Labor Council. He believes that part would require cops to hand over illegal immigrants to the feds, even if they were pulled over for a minor violation, like an illegal lane change.
If you pass such a law here in California, it's going to push that population out of California, and it's really going to hurt us here on the Central Coast in a drastic negative way.
Oviedo isn't as worried about business, but rather the people this would affect. Yes, she'll likely soon become an American, but she's still standing by her fellow immigrants.
Just because we come from another country doesn't mean that we don't deserve the same rights.
And the group that submitted this is based out of San Diego. They now have 150 days to get more than 500,000 signatures, which is the number required to get this on the ballot in November. Aaron?
All right, Tom, thank you. If the proposal becomes law, local law enforcement wouldn't get any extra money to enforce it.
The initiative, though, does call for $35 million to be transferred from the general fund to the Department of Justice to help fight what it calls transnational gangs.